This is Pat from Rain Country, and we've had questions before about how to treat rolling pins and chopping blocks or noodle boards or whatever have you, those types of things that you use in the kitchen quite a bit. The same application would go for wooden spoons, whether they're bamboo or birch or whatever kind of wood that you're working with. I have a maple French style rolling pin here, and I finish this off with the same finish that I use for all the rolling pins that I build. Here's a longer one here. This really brings out the wood. This is made out of a maple or maple lace. Here's a big heavy thick cutting board I just finished up. So the big secret is an all natural beeswax and coconut oil. Approximately a 50-50 solution of both. And what I got behind me here is some beeswax and coconut oil melting on the stove. Coconut oil melts at a real low temperature. You can actually put it in your hands and your hands will melt the coconut oil. And beeswax, it melts a little bit higher temperature. So we get beeswax and we put that in there, and that's actually the last to melt. It actually melts into the coconut oil. Here's the beeswax and coconut oil melted together. It looks like honey. So I just take this. It's actually really hot on the stove, so I've got to be careful how I touch that, so it'll burn me. But I go ahead and just take that off of the stove now. So I just put that on a trivet. And I have this taller trivet right here that I can just put the wood that I'm going to treat on here to kind of heat the wood up a little bit. The beeswax and coconut oil mixture will melt into that nicely if the board is warm. Okay, so I have the board heating up on the wood stove. The heat's radiating in the back. It's warming up the board pretty quickly. You want to be careful that you don't overheat the board. If there's any moisture in it, you know, you're liable to warp it or even crack the board if it's you know, if you heat it up too fast. So I keep rotating the board. I want to get it hot enough to where it'll absorb the oil treatment both in the ends and in the face of the wood, especially on the ends. It's really absorbent. So I recommend to anybody, if you're going to treat your cutting board or any of your cooking utensils like rolling pins and such, that you treat them quite often and you know, keep them from drying out. So I like to hit the ends first, get those starting to absorb the treatment. The ends are a lot more porous than the top of the cutting board. So I just treat that, flip it over all the while this board's heating up. Because this is an inch and a half thick board, it takes a little while for it to heat up. So we'll get that stuff to soak, or we'll get that treatment to soaking in, and we'll start on the face and sides. I just have bare hands when I'm doing this. It's no big deal because it's all natural. As that board heats up, the beeswax and coconut oil mixture will just start seeping right into that board. It'll soak right in. Now the bottom's getting a little bit warmer than the top, so I'll just go ahead and flip that over, hit the top again, hit the end grain again, so that's continuously starting to soak in the treatment. Now if you want to go with an all-natural finish like this, you could even finish off, if you build a set of cabinets or refinish anything, any cabinets like that, you could actually finish it off with beeswax and coconut oil mixture. We just keep letting that board heat up a little bit. We keep rotating it, letting that wax and coconut oil seep right into the wood. Now you might not be able to see it, but I can see just a sheen coming across here. So I know that's continuously soaking up that mixture, or soaking up the treatment. The warmer the board gets, the more absorbent it becomes. Now, realistically, if I had time, one would continuously come back or set this off to the side. You don't want to leave it unattended on the stove, obviously, or it might destroy the board or burn it. But we've treated a lot of our cutting boards by just setting them right next to the stove over here, where it stays warm enough to keep the coconut oil and or coconut oil and beeswax mixture soaking in, and it keeps in a warm environment, keeps the wood warm, and it you keep on applying the treatment until it completely saturates the board and it won't absorb it anymore. So anyway, I continue doing that until I feel that it's got a pretty good coating on here. You can see the end grain here a little bit. So anyway, hopefully that answers the questions that folks have been having. Thanks for watching. Take care and God bless.